हेलो,
हेलो।
इज देयर सुमित?
यस
हाय सुमित, योर इंटरव्यू वाज शेड्यूल फॉर टुडे।
या
इज इट राइट टाइम टू टॉक टू यू?
यस इट्स राइट टाइम।
ओके, लेट्स बिगिन योर इंटरव्यू। ओके, फर्स्ट टेल मी व्हाई स्ट्रिंग क्लास हैज़ बीन मेड इमिटेबल इन जावा।
या स्ट्रिंग क्लास इज इम्यूटेबल इन जावा। एज वी नो, इम्यूटेबल ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर द आइडियल फॉर रिप्रेजेंटिंग वैल्यूज ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डाटा टाइप्स लाइक नंबर्स, इन्यूमरेटेड टाइप्स ईटीसी। एंड इफ यू नीड ए डिफरेंट वैल्यू, क्रिएट ए डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट इन जावा। इंटीजर, लॉन्ग, फ्लोट, करेक्टर, बिग इंटीजर एंड बिग डेसिमल आर ऑल द इम्यूटेबल ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन जावा। एंड द ऑप्टिमाइजेशन स्ट्रेटजीज लाइक कैशिंग ऑफ हैश कोड, कैशिंग ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, ऑब्जेक्ट पुलिंग ईटीसी कैन बी ईजिली अप्लाइड टू इम्प्रूव द परफॉर्मेंस। एंड इफ स्ट्रिंग्स वर मेड म्यूटेबल देन स्ट्रिंग पुलिंग वुड नॉट बी पॉसिबल, एज चेंजिंग द स्ट्रिंग विद वन रेफरेंस विल लीड टू द रोंग वैल्यू ऑफ द अदर रेफरेंसेज। एंड ड्यू टू इम्यूटेबिलिटी इट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द थ्रेड सेफ्टी ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड दे कैन ओनली बी यूज एज रीड ओनली ऑब्जेक्ट्स। दे कैन ईजिली बी शेयर्ड अमंग द मल्टीपल थ्रेड्स फॉर द बेटर स्केलेबिलिटी।
ओके, हाउ यू इम्प्लीमेंट पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म इन योर प्रोजेक्ट?
नॉर्मली वी आर डेवलपिंग अवर एप्लीकेशन बाई यूजिंग इंटरफेस बेस्ड अप्रोच। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी हैव सर्विस लेयर इन अवर प्रोजेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर एंड सर्विस इम्प्लीमेंटेशन लेयर ऑल्सो। सो माई कंट्रोलर नीड टू इंजेक्ट सर्विस इम्प्लीमेंटेशन टू गेट द बिजनेस फंक्शनैलिटी बिकॉज अवर बिजनेस लॉजिक विल बी इन द सर्विस लेयर। सो इन दिस केस, इन कंट्रोलर क्लास वी आर इंजेक्शन सर्विस बीन बाई टेकिंग सर्विस इंटरफेस रेफरेंस। सो आई विल यूज एट द रेट ऑटो वाइड इन एनोटेशन टू इंजेक्ट द ऑब्जेक्ट।
How will you write code for this? Can you explain?
Yes, for example, we have an interface that is bank service interface, and in this interface I will declare one method like public void do transaction, and then I will create the implementation class for this interface like public class bank service implementation implements bank service interface. And now I must need to override the method of bank service interface. Then I will write the implementation for this method, and at class level I will use at the rate service annotation. So Spring will create the bean for this class, and I can use this bean inside our controller class. And if I want to use this business logic in our controller class, then I will create one class, public class bank controller, and I will use at the rate controller annotation at class level, and then I will create the object of bank service interface, and I will use at the rate auto void annotation on this. And here when I will declare like this, then internally IOC container instantiate my service bean as below, like this: bank service service is equal to new bank service implementation, create the new object.
Okay, what is serialization?
The serialization is a process where we can change state of object to the file over the network, or simply we can transfer our object from one layer to another layer. That's why Java provides a streaming API.
Have you implemented serialization in your project?
Yeah, in my project I used in Pojo class, means my Pojo class should be implements from serializable interface because that business object will be transferred over the network. That's why it's recommended to implement business object from serializable interface, and it is a marker interface.
Do you know about agile methodology?
We are also following agile methodology in our project.
What are the main roles in Scrum?
The Scrum consists of mainly three roles, like first is product owner, and here product owner usually represent the client and act as a point of contact from client side, and the one who prioritize the list of product backlogs with Scrum team should finish and release. And another is Scrum Master, that Scrum Master act as a facilitator to the Scrum development team and clarify the queries and organize the team from distraction, and teach the team how to use Scrum and also concentrate on return on investment. So it will be responsible for managing the sprint, एंड स्क्रम डेवलपमेंट टीम दैट्स डेवलपर्स एंड क्यूएस टीम वो डेवलप द प्रोडक्ट. स्क्रम डेवलपमेंट टीम डिसाइड द एफर्ट एस्टिमेशन टू कम्प्लीट ए प्रोडक्ट एंड डिफाइन द बैकलॉग आइटम्स. सो स्क्रम टीम ए क्रॉस फंक्शनल सेल्फ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ग्रुप ऑफ डेडिकेटेड पीपल्स लाइक दैट विल बी बिजनेस प्रोडक्ट ओनर एनालिस्ट एंड डेवलपर एंड क्यूएस टीम.
How to create web services project and Spring project using Maven?
Yes, we can create project like simply we have to create one Maven project. Like we can create Maven archetype web app and then add the dependency from our local repository. And if available then okay. Otherwise it will download from the sample repository in pom.xml and it will add the Spring dependency along with JaxWS implementation class dependency in our pom.xml, then it will download its dependency also. Like this we can create.
Okay, why wait method placed in object class, why not it is placed in thread class?
Yeah, very simple reason behind it. Actually wait method is used to wait the thread of execution and it used for inter-thread communication to avoid data inconsistency. So first reason is wait method and notify method also are not specific for single object. It can be applied on any object. And the second reason is it will represent in thread class, then one thread have to know the status of another thread. For example, we have four threads like thread 1, thread 2, thread 3 and thread 4. And thread 4, so in inter-thread communication lock will be applied on objects by thread. So which thread apply lock, that only known to object. So simply locking mechanism nowhere related to thread, it's related to object. So that was the main reason.
Okay, which design pattern you used in your project?
In my project, I have used modularization, singleton design pattern and facet design pattern and also used service locator design pattern.
Okay, where you implement multi-threading in your project?
As you know, I have 3 years of experience in development and I did not get a chance to work on multi-threading environment and this part is developed by our senior team members, but I have awareness on multi-threading and I know how to work.
Okay, how you implement exception handling in your project?
There are multiple ways, like normally we are developing Spring based application. So in Spring to handle exception, multiple predefined class is there. So simply in my project, we are throwing custom exception from service layer and then my controller calls service. It will catch that exception by using Spring AOP and we have to create a class which should be annotated as @controller_advice and we have to take one method whose return type is model and view. And the method should be annotated with the annotation like @exception_handler_annotation will be at method level. So in this method we have to write the logic for map the exception and return the same view which is returned by controller class at the time of exception rise, and we have to return some user understandable message by view page. So like this we implement the custom exception in our project.
Okay, now tell me, in your project where you used concurrent hash map?
Yes, I have used concurrent hash map in my project also. I did not remember the situation exactly, but in the situation where I have to write the code in map, I have to put the value inside map and same time I am reading the value from the map. In that situation we will also use concurrent hash map. Suppose I have one requirement where multiple threads want to access or modify the underlying data structure of map, means one thread try to insert element in the key and value pair and another thread try to modify the sum element at the same times, then in this situation better to prefer concurrent hash map, because instead of hash map it will raise the concurrent modification exception. So in this situation we must use the concurrent hash map, apply lock on the specific entry, not in the complete map object.
Okay. List out all annotation of REST used in your projects.
In my project, I have used mostly lots of annotations like @ application path annotation, @ path to define the path of the controller level, @ consumes will define the consume in which XML or JSON that we want to consume, and @ produces will also work same, and @ post annotation if I am writing the data into DB, and @ get to read the data from database, and @ put also to modify the already existing object, and @ delete annotation to delete the object from DB, and @ form param, and like this more annotation, @ path param, etc. we have used.
Okay, how to create a Spring Boot project?
In Spring Boot project, yes, we can. In Spring Boot project folder structure, the main method is the heart of the Spring Boot application to run the application. And on this class, we will use @ Spring Boot application annotation. And the @ Spring Boot application annotation is the same as we can also use @ enable auto configuration annotation, @ configuration, and @ component scan with default attributes. And like this, we can use @ Spring Boot configuration annotation, and we can use @ configuration annotation also at class level, and the main method will be the heart for this project.
Okay. How to implement Swagger 2 in your project?
Yes, we can implement Swagger to make the API documentation with Docker, and for this we need to use @ configuration annotation at class level, and we need to write @ enable Swagger 2 annotation, and this annotation enable the Swagger in our project. And we also need to create bean for Docker API, and it will return the return new Docker, and inside parameter we will write documentation type dot Swagger 2, and like this we will call select method and dot APIs method, and here is also that paths dot paths method and dot build method. Here we will write the path for the API. We can say that @ enable Swagger 2 annotation is used to enable the Swagger 2, and once the Docker bean is specified, select method returns an API select builder instance, and this instance is used to determine how to control the exposed endpoints, and request handler selector and path selector are used to configure predicates of for a request handler selection. And lastly, any dot any method that will facilitate the documentation using Swagger. So above configuration can be used to integrate Swagger 2 with the Spring Boot application.
Okay, what are the challenges you faced while using microservices?
Yes, we are already working on microservice architecture in our project, and microservices always rely on each other, so therefore they need to communicate with each other. As it is distributed system, it is a heavily involved model. If we are using microservice architecture, you need to ready for operations overhead. You need skilled professional to support heterogeneous distributed microservices.
How do you override a Spring Boot project default properties?
Yes, we can override the default properties of Spring Boot project, and this can be done by specifying the properties in application.properties file that will be available in our resource folder. And for example, in Spring MVC application, you have to specify the suffix and prefix, and this can be done by entering the properties mentioned below. In application.properties, we can like write spring.mvc.view.suffix .jsp, and for prefix we can write like this spring.mvc.view.prefix like its path / /web-inf. Like this we can overwrite, and we can also override the server.port, and we can define our manual port number on which our Spring Boot project will run.
Okay, what is the role of Equator in Spring Boot?
It is a new feature provided by Spring Boot, and it is the most important features like which helps you to access the current state of an application that is running in production environment. And there are multiple metrics which can be used to check the current state. They also provide endpoints of RESTful web services, which can be simply used to check the different metrics.
Okay, thanks. I have done from my side. If you have any query, then ask me.
No, I have not any query.